The new EIB climate survey we are releasing today found that a large majority of citizens, whether in Europe, China, or the United States, say that climate change is having an impact on their everyday life. Climate change is no longer an abstract concept for many people. They understand the stakes, in particular the young generation. The EIB climate survey found that while in 2019 climate change was the first challenge for the Europeans, it has slipped down the list of priorities now behind the COVID-19 pandemic, unemployment and the financial crisis. This is of course understandable given the immediacy of the crisis at hand. However, we need to make sure that people in general and decision makers in particular do not lose sight of the long-term challenges. We have to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic and its social and economic consequences, but we must not add to the climate and other environmental problems while doing that. In fact, these issues are related. The majority of Europeans demand a green recovery when building back our economies. At the same time, the goals of the Paris Agreement remain within reach, with the EU, China, Japan, South Korea, and the US president-elect, two-thirds of the world economy responsible for over 50% of global greenhouse gas emissions have pledged to become climate neutral by mid-century or soon after. But pledging is not enough. We now need more countries, cities, businesses, and financial institutions to come up with concrete plans, implement them, and show climate leadership. The European Investment Bank has become a climate leader for a long time. Today, we are one of the world's largest multilateral lenders for climate action and environmental sustainability. Last month, our shareholders, the 27 member states of the European Union, unanimously approved the EIB Group Climate Bank Roadmap. This plan will guide our activities in the next 5 years and beyond. Our roadmap focuses on 4 areas. First, by the end of this decade, the EIB Group aims to support at least 1 trillion euros in climate action and environmental sustainability investments. Second, we will support a just transition for regions, communities and businesses that are most vulnerable, not only to the shift to a low carbon economy, but also to negative impacts of climate change. Third, we will align all our new operations with the objectives of the Paris Agreement by the end of this year. We will no longer support unabated fossil fuel energy, carbon-intensive agricultural activity or airport expansions, for example. And fourth, as the pioneer of green bonds, we understand that transparency and accountability are key to mobilize sustainable finance at scale. We will continue to help developing the EU taxonomy for green investments and the EU green bond standard. Our work helps establish clear standards and definitions and prevents greenwashing, which makes green finance more attractive to private investors. Ladies and gentlemen, our new Climate Bank Roadmap is a milestone in our transformation to become Europe's climate bank for the EU and beyond. But we cannot do this alone. I call on all our partners to be ambitious and become global climate leaders. We have no time to lose. Thank you.